Welcome back, everybody. So, episode 2 of Sky Factory 3.0. And I think it's time we build a little bit larger platform. Not much has changed. I've done a little bit of sifting. So we got a little bit of iron and such like that, and yeah, that's still pretty loud. Try that. Done, resume. Okay, so we got a little bit of gravel and such here. Alright, I sifted maybe 3 or 4 stacks of gravel. I sifted 3 or 4 stacks of gravel and got the iron pieces and stuff like that, so we actually have a little bit of metal, but clearly not a lot of it. So what I thought we'd do today is try to kick it up one level and get some automated cobbling going. Oh, I also moved our lava system over to that location, so it generates faster, 3 times faster, when it's over the pool of lava instead of over a torch. Our little mob system here has actually been pretty well. I had a creeper explosion happen, like just after I finished recording the previous episode there. So a little bit unfortunate, but we are back in action here. Also, I made some tools. I actually have a full set of them now. So we have a flint broadsword. We have a bone pickaxe, a bone shovel, a bone hatchet, and a bone flint mattock. So we can actually cross that off of our list from bone or flint. We did bone and flint. I have also sieved... No, I still haven't done sand. So we got one more left in the wood age. But we built a darkroom 25 blocks away from our base. That one is done. We'll get to the grass in a second. I actually have been making quite a bit of dirt. But that's it. Not much else has changed. I figured we'd just do a little bit of building, a couple of quests, but mostly focus on the cobble gen this time around. So actually, let's... Yeah, I don't really have the materials yet to do a builder's wand. So let me place down the floor here. Give us a little bit more room to work with. And I'll return in a moment. And that is still way too friggin' loud. Holy crap. Blocks maybe? Sounds a bit better. Alright, so... Oh, I forgot. Okay, so... Built out the platform a little bit here, so we have more space to work with. And in here... Grass seeds. That looks pretty full to me. Oh, I set up a little auto dirt thing here, because I found out we have... this recipe right here. So, stone shears. Oof. Lots of stuff to then go and make dirt out of. Trees to replant. Quite easy. Queasy. Excuse me. But quite easy enough. We'll just put this stuff in here when we need it. Making sure we do not junk out the others. Oh, and I only had enough iron to do those two in good conscience. Have 6 more here. I got some more charcoal, but we have 2 of these inferium furnaces just from the mob farm and such. I was able to get enough inferium to make them. So, you know, no big deal there. And before we grow the grass here, I like this. The little subtle variations that you can get in the dirt blocks. That's kind of why it reminds me of Mises' texture pack, was that's what was going on with that pack at the time. Was, you know, even the things like the shovels and such had durability that you could visibly see on them. Is, you know, the more their durability went down, the more dented and broken the shovel looked. It was actually pretty cool. And look at all those mobs. Yeah. Getting me some Mizzy, yo. Whoa, don't shoot me. Oh, don't shoot him either. Oh my gosh. Good. Sorry. I heard a beat. Must obey the beat. Nope. Nope. And now the spider should be in... Come here, you. I have ways of getting you from over there. One of your other buddies dropped this. Yeah, yeah. Up you go. Slam. But yeah, that's been a very handy thing, and I think I saw this. What do we get? What do we get? You know what? That is not a bad deal. I will definitely take that. I wanted to make a, I thought we'd move some of our farming stuff over here, see, with the grass and stuff. This is going to make us the NPCs, but I want to fill this out with dirt with, I'll probably put, like... do that sort of deal, have this walk up and onto it, and just have this all be a nice little dirt field and such we can go around. I am still going to build the large island and such, that is still part of the plan, but I decided in the interim it doesn't have to look, bad either in the interim, you know? Gonna need to deal with some lighting issues though, and especially while I'm still flushing this out. However, this is not the main focus of... Oh, you people are the skewers of my dreams. Ah, you know what? I've been waiting for a good time to use this. I'm thinking the upper... Oh! Denied! I am really liking this texture pack. I thought the textures on the wood were maybe a little too busy when I first saw them. But honestly, I'm enjoying the variation. I'm enjoying a little bit of the detail. I wish it wasn't as fuzzy, I guess. I wish the patterns were a little bit clearer. But all things considered, yeah, I like this. I do like this. Let's get a little bit more of that plankage. I believe I can actually, yeah, if need be, I've made a little too many. I can go back and we can do this proper. Misreplacing this. Oh yeah. Alright, no matter what I do, one of those is going to have to come down anyways. Because if I built something up I could jump on top of, then I would have to have taken that back down. We would have basically been in the same situation we were already in. There we go. All nicely lit up. We have a nice little distinctive railing out and around there. That's gonna bug me. It shows that it's a spawn location, even though there's a barrel on top of it. And this is going to work out very, very well for us. It just, dirt makes itself faster when you don't have to constantly, you don't have to constantly be on its case, so to speak, I guess. Is I can just kind of let this go at its own rate. We'll flush that out. We'll get a nice little green pasture. We'll start doing a little bit of farming and stuff like that. But mostly, I'd like to see... I don't know... There's some weird mobs, okay? I'm gonna say that. There's some weird mobs in this pack. And one of them was, like, baby zombie height chicken. It was a chicken that stood up about yay tall and just sat there and stared at me, and I was like, should I let it out? And then I noticed it has a freaking sword in its hand. I did not let the chicken out. Just, you know, FYI. If I was supposed to do that, let me know, but I did not let the chicken out. I killed the chicken. I killed it dead. I love the discovery of that. Because I'm still getting enough of the saplings to continually go back and forth with it. Let's turn that back down. I'm out of torches. That's just... it's a very handy thing. You know? Works out well to my advantage. Let's just do a simple that and that. We'll move our garden over, but I want to focus on getting a cobble gen. Now, if we look at the achievement book... Automate your cobble with a cobblestone generator block or a transfer node. I thought we'd start with the cobblestone generator block since we've done the transfer node thing like every single time. Why not? So we'll just figure out what that's about. Cobblestone generator. Cobblestone generator. Tiny progressions. Oh, no, I can use clay. Okay. But lava and water, and glass. I'm gonna need some sand, some cobblestone. That actually looks very doable. Upgrade 8 iron. I've only got 6. Oh, I have no diamonds. Okay, so let's just see how fast this generates the cobble. Let's come into here. I've got 2 clay left. All right, for a temporary storage. No? Okay, so click and drag to get things in. Okay. Let's try and like shift Q, control Q. That seems to just have dropped it on the floor, but shift and drag works just fine. Let's just get a little bit of our inventory back. And what was I? Clay. Clay. Needed clay. Alright, let me work on that. Sifted sand. Okay, so one clay bucket of lava. One clay bucket of water. I kept some of the sand. I have it actually right here. Let's get this cooking down. I'm gonna do a little sifting. Put a piece of dust in there by mistake. Let's get that down. And nothing and nothing. I've kind of come to expect that. That's not exactly a very yielding thing. That is definitely something we will want to upgrade to automatic when we can. Oh, I just stuck all my cobblestone in the furnace. And there we go. 2, 4, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Come back to here. Perfect. Oh, it kept us the one for the water, but the clay was indeed destroyed. Alright, let's see what this does. I'm gonna set it. Okay. I put some extra chests. Oh, I dumped off a little extra stuff right in here for now. Of course. Yay, didn't break it. So, how does this thing work? Cobble? We need to... Does it? Oh. Okay, it. It made cobble. Just from being there. Oh, no, that's breaking a progression. I don't want to break it every time I want to get cobble out of it. Does it need to go on top, maybe? No. Already tried down below. How did I... 49? Can I just right-click it to get the cobble out? Okay. I would like it a little bit better if we could pipe it out, but I guess that kind of works. Just, you know, we'll get a little bit of cobble over time. I don't know. I might actually have to read up a little bit about tiny progressions and see exactly if there's a way to... No. Let's test. Yeah. All right, you guys go back up in there. In wait. Let's grab the other chest here. Nyaha! Nyaha! Victory is mine! Ah, that didn't... I'm like, that didn't just land in the lava, did it? Okay, I can see where this could be handy. Yeah, we can. They're cheap enough to make, and once we get our ores and such growing a little bit faster, I can see an upgrade and see how these kind of go. So, cool. Little bitty cobble gen. It's basically this setup here, without need for a pick. What it does require, though, or it does mean that if I want to go to gravel and such, we have to go beyond. We have to take it out and we still have to hammer it before I can sit there and I can gather, you know, a section of it at any given time. And it would just be straight gravel instead of having to pick it into the cobble and stuff like that. But that's not that big of a deal, all things considered. I'm content with that. That's actually pretty darn good. Okay, so we got our cobble gen miraculously a lot faster than I thought. I am going to now sacrifice... Ooh, where did I put... Okay, I got the iron on me. Let's do that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can have... Ah, it's floating there for a second. So we can have this sucker going again. Make sure we stay in a constant state of dirt. I think I have some more smooth stone here explicitly for making these. And you know, there was a mod... It was like a crafting frame mod or something like that. And I'm missing that right now. That would be so simple to set up to say, hey, you know, here's a chest with a whole bunch of smooth stone in it. And just click on a little crafting frame. It looks like an item frame, like what you'd attach to the wall and put out front. And it would give you the items crafted from the interior. All right, you're just a zombie. I've thought about redoing this. Yeah. No, don't be upset at each other. Don't be upset. Yeah. Okay. Okay. No. Okay. We're good. We're good. It's all okay. Oh, how dare you hit me, you little bastard! You. There we go. Okay, we're actually getting a good steady supply of heads. Two skeletons, one creeper, one zombie. So that's not too bad at all. Oh, two creeper. And the rotten flesh, of course. Actually, let me... I might have just been sticking this... Yeah, there we go. I got a golden apple a little bit ago, too. I thought that was pretty cool. Pretty darn cool. That's from a witch, so we know the witch is spawning here. Let's get rid of that. Let's get rid of that. One ender pearl. We're going to be saving that. And that iron ingot in there came from a zombie. I'm thinking about framing it. Let's get all that in here. Yeah, making us nice good amounts of dirt, which is actually going to help along our farm. Alright, so we've got our cobble gen, as we were kind of aiming for. And I'm just going to focus on filling in one side here as we go. Ah! I'm kind of eager to start working in on those chickens that we saw the other day. How they can grow just about anything. It looks like it's going to be a fairly large time investment. So the faster we can get some chicken eggs, the better in my particular opinion. Alright, there we go. Let's get our torch back out here. And I believe that was just in the corner, which will work. This guy's kind of in the center. We need about another, I'm going to say 30 or so dirt. I believe, let me see, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. So 33 for those strips, and then like say another 9, 18, 27, 28. So 61 or so more dirt, and we will have that whole thing there flushed out. I heard a... Sometimes I don't have to trick them down below. The bat problem is a serious problem, and I remember having it back in Agrarian Skies. It's because of our Y value. We're at 60 up here. It's only 58, so we're below the normal water level. Bat spawn, it's going to be an issue. When we get to building more seriously, we're going to be building up above. I will put in another drop farm, I'm thinking, kind of like what we had on Ozone 2 and such. Get the mobs going a little bit better. Want to make sure... Yep, we got plenty of lit up area. There's no problem there. I do believe... Like, I didn't quite put all the torches back up on top. I don't want to jump that. But I do believe we are safe. And, crap. Q key is how I put stuff away in other games. It's not supposed to throw it on the ground. Okay, so we have that. Let's cross that off of our little book. See if there's anything else. Click. Anything else that we can go. Upgrade your mob farm to automatically kill monsters. Okay. So, there's two steps I would need for that with the current system the way that I have it. Do we have fans in this mod? Mob fan? Mob grinding utilities. Mob fan. Pushes mob in the facing direction. Can be modified with upgrades. That looks like a whole bunch of stuff we can't make. Oh, actually, that is not too bad. What do you guys say we work towards that? A little bit upgrade for our farm. It's going to require me doing a little bit more sieving, so I will get to that. We will get some materials going here. I have a lot of gravel and, well, now we have... No. Sorry. We will get to that. What I wanted to do first was this stuff, the compressed stuff. Compressed wooden hammer is 9 friggin' hammers. 9 hammers. Hammers, compressed blocks though, breaks one block at a time. And if we look at... Compressed flint, really? What does that do? Nothing, it's just a way to store flint. So I knew that. So what can we do with... Yeah. So the heavy sieve, we actually almost made this the other day. See how it gives a little bit of a better chance there? We got some blaze powder, iron ore, lead ore. Millstone. So it changes up the kind of things... Oops, no. It changes up the kind of things that we're able to do, actually. So heavy sieve, draconium dust. Oh, yeah, that's the ender gravel. So let's do this a little bit. Let's look into getting... Well, first of all... A little bit of this stuff compressed. Oh, that finally works. Yay! So we got 12 of those compressed. Let's go straight up with the stone hammer. So we're going to need a good 9 of these. Oh, and I'm short by 1. Oh, no, that's stone. Let's go get our cobble. Oh, look at that. Yep, I'm happy that that is here. 19. We're good. So we'll go here. We'll go here. We'll put that in there. We get all friggin' 9. Put them all up and on and in. Okay. Sand, gravel, stone. Ah, compressed gravel. It's at the end already. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I was wondering about that, if it still floated in the air. Let's see if Bane Miner does not work, but this is actually going pretty dang fast. I'm kind of okay with that. So now that we have... Oh, it just gave us sand. It didn't stay compressed. I see. Okay, let's use the sand. Let's take a look at the sieve. Cactus seeds is going to be the key thing there. If we go back to here, we get to compress sand. Let's see what we can do with that. Compressed hammer, I'm assuming, is going to give us dust. Yeah. Heavy sieve. Eulorium, we don't really need that. Quartz, prosperity shard? Okay. Ancient spores, iron ore pieces, 24% chance for 7 of them. Cocoa beans, gold ore. That actually sounds pretty good. So what do you... Oh, iron stiffened mesh. Diamond stiffened. String mesh. Heavy on the iron, but iron is actually what we need right now. Flint stiffened. That actually gives us a little bit more, and we easily have that material. Okay. Let's do... I think I have enough in my inventory here. Grab that. Grab those. I put the flint over here. Heavy oak sieve. We just want the one. So we got that. Oh! Okay, and then we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that looks a little bit better. There we go. And I found out you can go just like that. I don't know. I was hoping there would be an upgrade path for these, but I guess not. Let's make another one. While we're here, though. Because these don't seem to have, like, any sort of durability. And we can just do that. It does strip out some of the other things that we could get. But for now, I think we're happier with the higher rate of success. Let's go with the sand. Straight on in like that. Middle mouse button to get that nice in there. Oh! Ha ha! I like that. That is pretty freaking cool. Oh, yeah. Alright, we will be working on this. Cocoa, yeah! Oh, look at all those resources. Sifting just plain old sand or gravel has never gotten me anything like this. Okay, I am curious, though. How do I get diamonds? Oh, man, this texture pack looks so cool. Sifting, gravel... Iron stiffened mesh, so it's basically the thing we had, but with iron. That might be the next good upgrade here. do. It does not look like 3% chance, 1% chance, and it doesn't look like the heavy. Oh, heavy? Iron stiffened, 1% chance, but for 7 of them. Ooh, along with lapis. Alright, we definitely have some options here. Let's get all this stuff to where it's safe. I don't want it to despawn on me. I kind of like how there isn't all the different tiers, but I miss going through the cycling of the materials down to the useful. Well, not that the other stuff's not useful, but, you know, getting that little bit, putting in the extra effort, and getting the little bit of ore duplication and such. But I really wanted to try out the heavy sieve and stuff that we have. Okay, so I'm going to go through, I'm going to get us the iron that we need for that fan. Although, fancy, no, fancy, cleaning fan, fancy. I have not used Steve's carts. I've been in mod packs with it before. I have never gotten around to actually using it. So yeah, iron and some redstone. I'll be back after I do a little bit more of this. You know, guys, there's just something oddly satisfying about doing this. Whoop. Okay, so a little bit more of iron cooking down, but I think we are ready to build this and see. Alright, let's see exactly how this works. Ah, okay. Does it do... It doesn't do nothing on its own, does it? I take back every mean thing I said about this, by the way. It was able to give me a lot of cobblestone. Whoa, son of a... One, two, three, four, five, six. Wait a second. It's only one wide. Okay. So for our hallway here, we're gonna need at least... Whoa, we're gonna need to clear this out. We're gonna need at least 3 of these. Whoa. Nope. Was that good? It's good! I'm sorry, dude. I enjoy your videos. I wonder if this will even work on the bats. So most of the mobs are too tall. Okay, I saw upgrades. Modifier width +1. I'm going to assume that's 1 to each side? Ooh. Block of aluminum, aluminum rods. Oh, that's 17 aluminum? That's a lot. Block of iron, iron rods. For height, steel. It might just be cheaper to do that a couple of more times. I do think I have some aluminum in here somewhere. Yeah, 12. That's enough for not even one of the upgrades. All right, let's make a couple of more of these then. Oh, I need more slabs. Should be enough for 2 more actually, right? There we go. Okay, so let's take that. Okay, I was worried. It was going awfully slow. Taunting me. How dare you? Grab a little bit of food here. Nah, nah. Nah, nah, nah. How did that not kill you? Okay, so I did end up padding this back wall a bit. I'm thinking if we do that. Oh, stone. Let me... I can't make this safe. Okay, stay safe while I'm not here. Not looking for any red dots. Two more of them. Still not looking for red dots. I can craft these in my inventory. Pig! Yes! Chicken? Chicken! Crap. Okay, no, they should be fine. Focus. Bink. Click. Ooh. Oh, wow. Well, we have a problem. The irony of that is not lost on me. They don't push far enough, and steel was the hardest one to make. I need them to go... two more blocks. So this is actually making our... Let's do this a little safer. Alright. So that means nothing can be back here. If we just waffle this, that should stop all the spawn. Oh, I need to do out here as well. So waffle. Alright, not the best automated mob farm. Oh, actually. No safari nets. Okay, good to know. The next step of making this automated going to be... well, honestly, I'd really, really like a torch. Let's grab a torch. Let's actually just grab that torch. Marginally safer. Okay. Chicken, real quick. I still see the chicken egg. Let's get in here. Yes. Usage. No, I don't want to make cakes. Yep, chicken eggs. Okay, so we can just start with the normal eggs, surrounded by the flowers that we need. Although that is, it's only a chance. So we're going to need to kind of automate these guys. Get them into a nice little chicken farm. Don't jump out. Come on, little piggy. You'd be safer than that. No. Oh my gosh, these guys are hard to move. Just... come on. There you go. I feel safer. Oy. Okay, So... punji sticks. They are actually in here, but they require sugarcane. So to get sugarcane, nature essence, mana infusion of a hay bale. Those are the only two ways to get sugarcane? Ah, sugarcane seeds, okay. Sifting, dirt, 4% chance. Compressed dirt, 4% chance, but for 7 of the suckers. Okay, a little bit more off screen. Try to get those up and running. We're going to have to deal with the chickens and such in the next episode. So. Still recovering. Okay. 9 dirt. Alright, this is going to take a little bit. Ooh. Alright, sorry about that. I had a little bit of a cough fit here. And, so, going to deal with... Ew! Seriously? Chicken poop? Oh. That's not too shabby. Okay. We're going to deal with those guys and set them up a little bit more in the next episode. That will definitely be our focus, get something a little bit more automated with them going. For this place, we have the fans set up. No, we derped up the fans. Oh, something looked odd. Alright, be prepared for death. Yeah, that's right, I took those out already. So, we have... No. We have that set up, and the only sticks I know of, like, well, spikes, that I know of that would kill them for sure are the punji sticks from Tinker's Constructs, which are in this pack. So we could do that, and... Oh, they're part of a loot bag? Seriously? Yeah, that's gonna take a while to get, though. Sugarcane is obtainable through Exnihilo from dirt and compressed dirt. String, flint. Flint, 8% chance on the flint. What I have over here, though, these are actually upgraded to iron stiffened. I actually got a pretty good mix, but I do have the flint stuff back here, so we probably set up a couple of these. That would actually be more handy. The other thing, we had these spikes. That's just 9 plus 15. Iron ingots. That's a lot of iron ingots. These ones are even more, but they would give us 4. Honestly, this is 18, and this might be what we end up having to go with. But I thought we would try the stone spiked ones real quick. Stone sword, stone. That's all cobblestone. That should be something that's easily done. So, oh, and does this give us 4 as well? And that'll give us 4. Cool. So we don't need to make a whole bunch. Let's just do that. 1, 2. And I'm gonna need one more, aren't I? That in there. That around there. And kudos, I think it's Bonnie that's keeping Tinker's Construct and up to date now. You know, Dio still sitting in the title, stuff like that, but I think it's Bonnie mostly. So if we do that... No. We're going to need to do... Alright, this might be bad and stupid, but testing must happen. Okay, so they will take damage if they... If they fall on them. Let's get rid of that. Let's put that up there. My thoughts here are that this will let us put collection down below, They'll fall up here up above. This will not help with spiders. We will need to do something about that. I'm not overly concerned about it at this point in time. I could actually even, you know, put a set of, like, oh, well, here. There. Spider comes up that way. It's too wide. It'll have to hit it, right? Right? I don't know if the shortened area is actually going to affect the spawn or anything like that. So it's kind of just a wait and see. Oh, piggy! You make me so nervous! Okay, so... let's just grab the eggs. I need to get a little bit of a farm going so we can just start breeding the chickens and get more of them that way. I really wish I could just say, spawn! Spawn right now. I would like to see if this actually works. Oh, guys? Something spawned. Come on. Alright. Yeah! Okay. Test one complete. Oh. Test number two complete, and we have what I would consider issues with this. First of all, the pushing doesn't look like it went far enough. It was still able to hold on to the edge. Oh, little fire damage here. Took care of it though, it's all good. Let's grab up this. We're going to have to put some thought into how we're going to do the mob farm. I do think the Pungy 6 are probably going to be our best bet. They're half a block high, which is what makes them unique. And they do continuous damage. I do believe they drop stuff. It just feels like we should be going with them. So anywho, lots of advancements done in this particular episode. I'm going to continue to do a couple of things off-screen, like probably set up a little farm for them so we got some more chickens to deal with for the next episode. And I'll also start trying to get some sugarcane, I guess, so we can try to figure out how to better progress with our automated mob farm. So to wrap up, let's just take a quick look. We got that going. We do not have a second layer. No. No. Not yet. Yeah. Not to my satisfaction. We've automatically killed a couple of things. I had to poke them to kind of get it started. Ooh, I didn't know we could enchant these. Something else to look into. Snap? Okay. Nesting pens to automate resource collection from chickens. Next episode. Iron seat. Nope. Okay, so I think that's all we're going to get done for... Oop, we did do this. Sand. Yeah. Book complete. Ha ha ha. Anywho, guys. Thank you for joining me. Hey, I'm not boogly-eyed. No boogly eyes. Yay! Thank you for joining me for this episode, and I hope you enjoyed it. We will be back on the third one, where we do a little bit more farming. Mostly livestock, I think, is what it's going to be. Both hostile and non-hostile. Until next time, though, take care, and I will see you when I see you.